So a disaster is an event that causes great harm, damage, even death sometimes, in general difficulties to the society where it takes place. It can be of a different nature. It can be caused by the human action, and also it can be a natural disaster, which can be also induced by the human indirectly as a result. That would be the case of climate change induced disasters. But in general, we have had disasters for our entire history. So that's a regular event that happens after a period. We don't know when, but we know that they will hit. So disasters have been living with people, with human societies for all of our history. So they are not new. The problem that introduces climate change is that the distribution of this disaster is changing. When we say that distribution is changing, we mean that the frequency and intensity with which these disasters hit us is being modified by climate change. There are many examples of how this may happen. One example that may be related, for example, to water risks, droughts or floods. We always had during our entire history droughts or floods. Only right now they may be more frequent. Also, in some places are less frequent and more or less intense. In those areas that right now are suffering a higher exposure to disaster and higher, and they are more vulnerable to disasters, this may have a larger economic harm as they used to have in the past. Obviously, disaster risk is not only connected to water-related risk. We have risks of many different nature. For example, we may have heat waves. During the recent years, the heat waves in Europe have hit increasingly harder. We have had, as a result of that, some deaths. So these risks are also increasing as a result of climate change, of the increase of temperatures and the increase also of the extremes. Exposure and vulnerability are two concepts that define risk. The first one, exposure, relates to the area and the people and the assets in there that can be affected, potentially affected by the risks. While the vulnerability reflects the degree to which these people, area, and assets in this area can suffer damage and harm as a result of that risk. Economic resilience has received many different definitions a long time. There is not a single one that can be applied to this thing, but I can give you three different approaches that are complementary among them. The first one considers resiliency as the ability of the society and also the assets within that society, the economy, to resist the impact, the direct consequences suffer from a disaster. So if you have a flood, for example, the resilience in this case will be the ability to reduce the damage that are realized as a result of the flood. The second concept refers to the ability of the system to recover from that negative event. So that will refer, for example, to the ability of businesses to reopen and start doing their activities once again after the event has hit them. Obviously, the longer it takes to recover, the higher will be the economic damages. The third one, and this is a new concept that has been recently introduced by some researchers, refer to the ability to induce an effective capacity to be, let's say, disaster-proof. So to be proactive, and instead of talking about the impact that you suffer and your ability to recover from that impact, to actively reduce the impact that you can suffer as a result of them through actions that can prevent you from being vulnerable. Now, when we talk about disaster risk reduction, we don't understand it as the ability of a society to be resilient ex post after the event hits and during the event hits. We also try to be more proactive. This is one of the objectives, or was one of the initial objectives, of the Sendai Framework for Disaster Risk Reduction. In the zero draft, there was mentioned that the nations and also international players should try to introduce more proactive ways to incentivize effectively disaster risk reduction. So we are talking about the third concept of resilience we were talking before. But finally, in the final draft, the text remained much more vague. So they are not talking about this. They are talking about substantial improvements in disaster risk reduction. So this concept was somehow like removed from the final text, but it still is there. So many people are talking about being more proactive. And to me, that's what means really disaster risk reduction, to be, even when you are not hit by a disaster, when you know that this disaster may not hit you in the near future, to be prepared to face the disaster and to minimize economic harm and human losses when it comes.